Breaking tonight in a Kelly Pyle exclusive, we have new reaction from a top GOP presidential candidate after President Obama today suggested he is ready to take a tougher stand against the Islamic State terror group, yet then made a pivot, sort of, to climate change. Listen.
This barbaric terrorist group poses a serious threat to all of us. It cannot be tolerated. It must be destroyed. We cannot and we will not succumb to fear. Next week, I will be joining President Hollande and world leaders in Paris for the Global Climate Conference. What a powerful rebuke to the terrorists it will be.
Joining me now, presidential candidate and Republican senator from Texas, Ted Cruz. Senator, good to see you tonight. So President Obama came out and tried to strike a tougher tone on the subject of ISIS today. What did you make of it?
Well, Megan, it's good to be with you. You know, it's gotten to the point where I don't think Saturday Night Live can even parody this president anymore. A couple of weeks ago, he went overseas and he said he's not interested in America leading. He's not interested in America winning. He doesn't have time for that. And now he's saying what a powerful rebuke it is to ISIS that he's going to a global warming summit.
Well, in Paris.
I mean, how out of
in
touch.
Paris.
And yes, but his focus, listen, President Obama and John Kerry have both said that they think essentially your SUV in the driveway is a greater threat to our security than is ISIS, than is a nuclear Iran, and it makes no sense whatsoever. You know what would be a real rebuke to ISIS? When we kill the terrorist before they carry out another terror attack here at home, murdering innocent
Americans.
When you
listen to him, he said today, this is a barbarous group, that they're a serious threat, that they must be destroyed. Do you think this was in reaction to the criticism he received over his initial reaction to the Paris attacks, or do you take him at his word on what he said today?
Well, look, he's finally using the adjectives for ISIS that he usually reserves for Republicans and for conservatives. So I guess that's a step in the right direction. But at the end of the day, he still refuses to utter the words radical Islamic terrorism. He still has no strategy for defeating ISIS. And he still wants to bring to America tens of thousands of Syrian Muslim refugees, even after his own FBI director admitted this administration cannot vet the refugees to ensure they're not ISIS terrorists. That doesn't make any sense.
Let me shift gears with you now to the politics, because there's been an extraordinary shift in the presidential race. You may be familiar with it. And it inures to your benefit. I mean, all the headlines today were about Ted Cruz and Cruz control in Iowa. Take a look at the numbers for the viewers who haven't seen it. Ted Cruz is now basically tied for first. He's behind Donald Trump by 2 points, but man, you're right there in the margin of error in Iowa, besting Carson and the rest of the field by at least 5 points. What do you make of it? What do you attribute your surge?
Well, listen, the energy and momentum we're seeing both in Iowa and nationally are nothing short of breathtaking. And this is a continuation of what has been happening steadily after the third debate, after the fourth debate, which is that we're seeing conservatives unite behind our campaign. What Washington has always wanted is to divide conservatives, to have us splintered, a chunk of conservatives here, chunk of evangelicals, a chunk of libertarians, a chunk of Tea Party folks. It's a mistake we've made over and over and over again, whether it was Bob Dole or John McCain or Mitt Romney. Every time we listen to the voice of run to the middle, we get clobbered. It doesn't work. They're all good, honorable men, but what they did didn't work. And I think what Republican primary voters are looking for is the strongest proven conservative, someone who's a consistent conservative, someone who's the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow, and also someone who can unite all three legs of the Republican stool
fiscal conservatives, social conservatives,
and national security conservatives.
You voted to undo the NSA, which is now you're getting hit by some on the right, but you're the mainstream moderate guy, they say. They say you voted to undo the NSA protection. And you should have moved
Let's speak the truth. I'm not getting hit by anyone on the right. I'm getting hit by a PAC. By a PAC supporting Marco Rubio.
Our leaders must keep America safe. But when Ted Cruz had the chance to fight Barack Obama's dangerously weak anti-terror policies, he didn't.
Marco Rubio's PAC is doing this because they desperately want to change the discussion from his longtime support of President Obama's massive amnesty plan. This PAC ad by Rubio's supporter, where they're spending hundreds of thousands of dollars, Listen, what it really is, Megan, is it's a sign of desperation. They want to try to change the topic because I think Marco's campaign is determined that his longtime support of Chuck Schumer and mm-hmm. Barack Obama's amnesty plan, particularly making it easier to bring Syrian Muslim refugees into this country, that they're now worried about it politically, so they want to change it with a false attack act.
And the latest polls show the public of 67% there against letting the refugees in. Senator Ted Cruz, it's always great talking to you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Megan. It's great to be with you.